Dear students, in this segment, we are going to study the Rengikuta method of fourth order. Actually, it is an effective and most widely used method for solving the initial value problems of first order differential equations. Let the given differential equation be dy by dx is equal to f of xy with the initial condition y of x naught is equal to y naught. And at the horizontal spacing will be known to you. Then x1 means x0 plus h, x2 you can calculate as x1 plus h and so on. Now corresponding to x1 you need to find y1. So similarly corresponding to x2 you need to find y2, which can be found out using the Rengikuta method of fourth order. So let us see the working rule of Rengikuta method of fourth order. We have yn plus 1 is equal to yn plus k, where k is equal to 1 by 6 into k1 plus 2k2 plus 2k3 plus k4. Actually, this is known as the weighted average of the values k1, k2, k3, k4 with the weightage as k1 and k2 with weightage 1 and k2 with weightage 2 respectively. Then you can find out k as using the weighted average formula 1 by 6 of k1 plus 2k2 plus 2k3 plus k4. Now the step is to find out the values k1, k2, k3, k4 only by knowing which you can find out k. So k1 means what? H into f of xn yn. K2 means h into f of xn plus h by 2 comma yn plus k1 by 2. K3 means h into f of xn plus h by 2 comma yn plus k2 by 2. And the last value k4 is h into f of xn plus h comma yn plus k3. So only in the case of k2 and k3, instead of h, half of h is taken. And in the case of k2, to get the y coordinate, we are using the term k1 by 2, and in the case of k3, instead of k1 by 2, we will use k2 by 2. So if you keep this difference into mind, it is very easy to learn by heart the formula for finding k1, k2, k3, k4. Using these values and using the weighted average method, you can find out k, using which you can find out yn plus 1 as yn plus k. So this is the general formula. Now when you put n equal to 0, what you will get? Y1 is equal to y0 plus k. In order to get k, you require the values k1, k2, k3, k4, where k1, k2, k3, k4 found out using the values x0, y0 and h. X0, y0 means the initial values and h means the horizontal spacing, which will be known to you. So using which you can find out k1 as h into f of x0 y0, k2 means h into f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2, k3 means h into f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k2 by 2, k4 means h into f of x0 plus h comma y0 plus k3. So once you get k1, k2, k3, k4, you will get k, and after getting k you can evaluate y1 as y0 plus k, that is corresponding to x1 which is equal to x0 plus h. The y1 value will be y0 plus k. So once you get x1 and y1, you can move to the next step. If you want to find y2, y2 means how will you find y1 plus k, where k means again 1 by 6 of k1 plus 2k2 plus 2k3 plus k4, and k1 is found out using the formula h into f of x1 y1. So in this case, instead of x0, y0, we have stepped one unit forward, that is instead of x0, y0, we are using here x1 and y1, where x1 is equal to x0 plus h and y1 means which you will get using by putting n equal to 0 in the above equation. So after getting x1, y1, y2 means by finding k1, k2, k3, k4 using the point x1, y1 and k, you will get y2 as y1 plus k. Similarly, you can find out y3, y4, etc. So this is the common procedure. Now, let us do some problems based on Runge-Kutta method of fourth order. So first question will be, apply Runge-Kutta method of fourth order to find an approximate value of y at 1.1 given that dy by dx is equal to y square plus xy and the initial condition is y of 1 equal to 1 and the spacing, horizontal spacing is given to you as h is equal to 0.1. So here you need to find y at 1.1. What does it mean? Y at 1.1 means when x takes value 1.1, what will be the corresponding value of y? Okay. So here the differential equation is given to you as dy by dx is equal to y square plus xy. And the initial condition is y of 1 equal to 1 means what? X not equal to 1 and y not equal to 1. Spacing is given to as 0.1. Now, so first step is to find x1. So here x1 is x0 plus h, that is 1 plus 0.1, which is equal to 1.1. That is, you need to find y at 1.1 means corresponding to x1, you are required to find what will be your y1. So here corresponding to this x1, we need to find y1, which will give you y of 1.1. For that you need to find k1, k2, k3, k4. So here f of xy is y square plus xy. X0 means what? It is equal to 1. Y0 means 1 and h is 0.1. Once these values and the equation is known, you can find out k1, k2, k3 and k4 respectively. So first step is to find k1. K1 means how will you find? H into f of x0, y0. So h is 0.1. X0 means 1. Y0 means 1 means you have to find the value of the given function at 1, 1. So which will give you 0.1 into 1 square plus 1 into 1. That is 0.2. Similarly, k2 means what? H into f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2. X0 means 1 plus h means 0.1 by 2 comma y0 means what? 1 plus k1 means already you got it as 0.2. So 0.2 by 2. So f of x0 plus h by 2 comma y0 plus k1 by 2 means you will get it as f of 1.05 comma 1.1. So k2 is 0.1 into f of 1.05 comma 1.1. That is 0.1 into 1.1 the whole square plus 1.05 into 1.1, which will give you 0.2365. So once you get k2, you can go move on to k3. K3 means how will you find out? H into f of x0 plus h by 2. That is the x coordinate will be same as that of the case of k2. Only in the case of a y value, instead of k1, you have to use k2. So you will get f of 1 plus 0.1 by 2 comma 1 plus 0.2365 by 2, which is f of x coordinate is 1.05 and y corresponding y coordinate is 1.11825. So find the value of f at 1.05 comma 1.11825, multiply it using 0.1, you will get k3 as 0.2425. Similarly, k4 means you will get h into f of x0 plus h comma y0 plus k3 is the formula using which you will get 0.1 into f of x0 means 1 plus h means 0.1 comma y0 is 1 plus k3 means already we got it as 0.2425. So you will get k4 as 0.1 into 1.2425 the whole square plus 1.1 into 1.2425, that is 0.2910056. So by this method you got the values of k1, k2, k3, k4. Next step is to get the value of k. So value of k means you will get as 1 by 6 of k1 plus 2 into k2 plus k3 plus k4. So this is the weighted average, where when you substitute k1, k2, k3 and k4, you will get the value of k as 0.2415. So once you get k, easily you can find out y1 as y0 plus k, that is 1 plus 0.2415. That is 1.2415. So here you can stop, because corresponding to x equal to 1.1, you need y. So here x1 itself is 1.1. So corresponding to which y1 is 1.2415. So this is the solution of the differential equation when x takes value 1.1. Thank you.